many years ago when I was less grey hair and a bit fitter, I used to be a competition runner in Tasmania, and that's big in Victoria. So my first taste of Victoria as a very young firefighter, I guess, was when we used to come across and run in the state championships. And I actually thought then, well, what a great organisation, how big it is. They seem to have everything that opens and shuts. And it was just, you know, almost a bit starry-eyed coming from a small state and a small service to come and have a look at a big service. And that's, I guess, I've always from that point had an eye on CFA.
So I'll get you to introduce yourself and
your
position.
Okay, just a straight name and title, yeah.
Yeah.
Gavin Freeman, I'm the Deputy Chief Officer responsible for urban portfolio within CFA. It was a bit of a long road for me to get to CFA. I started my fire service career way back in 1985 with the Tasmania Fire Service as a recruit. I came from a farming background and in Tasmania, and that was what I thought when I left school at 15, that I'd be a farmer for the rest of my life. Never panned out that way. While I enjoyed that time, I realised pretty quickly that the family farm wasn't going to support an extra income at that point. So I started looking for jobs, and at 19 I picked up a career or a job with the Tasmania Fire Service, which rapidly became my career. I spent 32 years in Tasmania and worked in a range of areas, from firefighter on station officer, district officer, and ultimately working as the Deputy Chief for Tasmania Fire Service for the last 7 years. After that, I decided I needed a different challenge, a different change. Over the time in Tasmania, I'd done some secondments, one to Victoria, to the Fire Service Commissioner then. I'd been fortunate enough to deploy to North America a couple of times and to most states in Australia. So I knew there was a world outside of Tasmania. And 6 months before I started with CFA, I had an opportunity to undertake a secondment in the Northern Territory, which really reinforced for me that it was time for a change and I had something else to offer. And when the position came up with the Country Fire Authority, I jumped at it and was fortunate enough to be offered a job. So it's almost been 12 months now. In September, it'll be 12 months since I've been with CFA, and it's flown, and I'm loving every minute of it, and absolutely no regrets about making the move. When I first started in the role, the chief officer said to me, you know, you've only got a couple of priorities, learn what your portfolio is all about, learn to understand CFA and get ready for the fire season, because it was September, so we were about to launch into our summer season. So pretty simple and clear priorities were set from the chief, and I had a preconceived idea of what the urban portfolio would entail, but things like the Coast Guard, perhaps emerging medical response, and the operational comms side of the business that we've picked up on top of the more obvious areas of urban probably weren't on my radar. But it's great. I've spent some time with the people that lead those areas, and they're doing a fantastic job, and they've really been helpful to help me understand what's required of those areas, and it's fantastic to be able to try and provide as much support as I can to keep those areas moving. And it's been a little bit dynamic. When I started, there was only one other substantive deputy chief officer and a couple of vacancies. Those vacancies have now been filled. So we now have a team of deputy chief officers all permanently in position, working with Chief Officer Warrington to really drive CFA forward. So that's been one big change. We've moved from what was a little bit of period of uncertainty to now getting some stability. And now our challenge is to transfer that down into the regions and down to the districts. Over the years, through my connections across the country, got to know quite a lot of the leadership team within CFA, and I have enormous respect for them, for past leaders that I knew and the current leadership team. So all of those things lined up, and then the position came up, and I've got to declare my hand completely. My wife's family come from Victoria, so that was also another driver to be able to come back home. And on top of that, our daughter's a police sergeant here in Melbourne, so we actually have more family connections to Victoria than we do in Tasmania at this point. So it was a logical step, really. It just seemed to be the natural thing to do, come to a fantastic organisation, a new challenging job, and be able to link it back up with family at the same time was just wins all around. So when I walked in day one, while I had to meet a lot of new people and learn a new organisation, I was very confident that it was going to come quickly, and I was right. Very quickly, I realised that all of the people in CFA are fantastic people. They weren't being distracted by anything else. They were just focused on delivering a service to the Victorian community, and I still see that today. So, fire agency people across the world are fantastic people at heart, and the CFA people are no different. They're great, and it's just I'm looking forward to meeting more of them. One of the big challenges for me, of course, is exactly that. Victoria and CFA are such a large state, a lot of brigades and a lot of people to get around, and every day I'm almost meeting somebody new, and I expect that to continue for a little while, but I hope to get around the state much more in the next few months, now that I've been able to settle in and learn about what my job role is, to get out and actually learn what the real challenges and the real issues are for the people that make it happen for us. The urban portfolio is quite diverse. Clearly we have responsibility to maintain CFA's urban service delivery, so response to emergencies in the build-up areas of country Victoria. And that includes obviously preparing for brigades for structural fires. It includes all the rescue disciplines, road crash rescue, technical rescue disciplines such as vertical and trench, steep angle rescue. We also look after the emergency medical response, the EMR component within CFA. Under the urban portfolio also is operational communications, which is exactly that, all the CAD, the infrastructure, the radios and the FSCCs that work in our call centres, so we have responsibility for those. We also now look after the wellbeing team within CFA, which has some great synergies with the EMR work that we're doing because of the extra exposure, additional exposure our frontline responders now get to trauma. Having the support services that help them in the wellbeing team and all the fantastic programs that they run just makes great sense, and it seems to be really kicking some big goals. We're winning some, getting some good wins in that area. We also have responsibility for the rehab team, so they're the teams that respond with our firefighters to do health monitoring, blood pressure monitoring, and make sure that they're safe if they're going into multiple entries into fires, for example. The other component that we pick up, which is almost a bit of an anomaly, is the Coast Guard. CFA have a number of Coast Guard brigades, and we work hand in glove with that. The Coast Guard brigades are actually CFA brigades, but they also function as a Coast Guard flotilla as well. But so where there's a fire on water, our CFA Coast Guard brigades will respond to that, and we provide support to them. The deputy chiefs obviously have a very close relationship with the chief officer. Chief Officer Warrington runs an approach where it's very much team-based. Clearly the chief has ultimate responsibility for, under the Act, for the operational performance and of the CFA, but the deputies in my role are there to support the chief. We very much play a support role. The chief is the leader of our organisation in terms of service delivery and operations, but the deputies are there to make sure that we interact with our people across the ground. The chief is one person, he can't be everywhere, so we see our roles as deputies very much as the interface between the response across the state through the regions and the districts to the chief officer, and providing advice and support to the chief to make sure that we continue to keep Victoria safe. When I first started, there was some frustration from across our volunteer and career workforce around training around low voltage fuse removal and safe working at heights, and again there'd been a lot of good people put in some effort into trying to get that up and running and get our capability improved in that area. What we've been able to achieve in the last little while is forward movement on that. We've got some training planned now, the programs have been designed, and that was through collaboration very closely with DCA Patterson in training, and just I take the approach that it needs to be a team focus on everything we do, and the other deputies have the same approach. So since in the last few months I think we've been able to actually get things moving. We haven't got all the results we want yet. It'll take in some cases 2 to 3 years to finish things because it is such a big organisation, but at least we're heading in the right direction in some of those key areas that perhaps have been gaps or stagnated a little bit in the past. So that being part of that team approach with the leadership team is a really positive thing, and I'm relishing that and looking forward to doing more of it. But what I can So I'm very proud of is I've been able to provide support to the urban team to either finish projects that perhaps they hadn't been able to get done previously. And one of those, for example, is the field guide that's a combined publication between MFB and CFA. It's been ongoing for 2.5 years. Last week it went to the printers. So that was a nice win and fantastic work by the people in the team. Look, if I could have my time over again and if I could sit down with the 19-year-old me that started as a recruit, I would probably tell them to make more of the opportunities. I mean, I've had a fantastic career, I've been really fortunate, but probably didn't appreciate how fortunate I was in the early stages of my career. So just being able to be part of a fantastic team, be doing a job that where you really make a difference to the community and can make a difference to people's lives. At the time, I was having a great time, really enjoying it, but I didn't really appreciate how lucky I was to be in a job like this. Now looking back, it's quite obvious to me, it's been fantastic, but you know, if I could just say to anybody that's starting out now, remember, it's one of the best jobs in the world and you've got the opportunity to really make a difference and enjoy that journey all the way along and take every opportunity that's thrown at you. If I could send just one message out to the wider CFA, I mean, coming in with a relatively fresh set of eyes, I'm one of the newest people in the organisation, having been here less than a year, but I do have a lot of experience in the industry. What I can say is that CFA is a fantastic organisation. It's one of the biggest fire services in the world. I think it is one of the best fire services in the world. And I think people need to remember that and celebrate what they do that's really well. I suppose it would be easy to you know, feel down because of the uncertainty around where CFA will be going forward. There's a reform agenda that's out there. Of course, we can't ignore that, but CFA people are really doing a fantastic job of keeping the Victorian community safe. There will always be a CFA, in my view, and it will continue to grow from strength to strength. So my message is just don't be hard on yourselves. Recognise what a fantastic job that you do and how important you are to the Victorian community and focus on that. Keep doing a great job. That's what you're good at.